Welcome back to The Gist. We are joined by Wendy Mejia, who, her husband, Franklin, is very famous to Catholic TV. He's a deacon who does the Mass on Sunday, the Latino Mass on Sunday, right?
That's correct. Yes.
But of course, you're a busy mom of two children, and you have a lot going on in your life with your ministries as well. Thank you so much for joining us today.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you so much for having me. Yeah, I have to ask you first, absolutely. How is it to be the wife of a deacon?
It's a blessing, and it's busy, and it's really a lot of work within the parish, a lot of juggling. Mm-hmm. As women, you know, we know how to juggle everything, or at least we try.
Right?
We try.
The help of the Holy Spirit.
So it's about juggling family life, work, and also religious life as well.
So when he came to you and said, you know what, I feel like I have this additional vocation, because of course you have the vocation for marriage, mm-hmm. but I feel like God is calling me to become a deacon. What was your reaction?
Well, I was surprised. I truly was. I had met my husband, Deacon Franklin, within the youth group, within parish youth ministry.
Which is so cool.
Which is awesome.
Oh,
it's awesome. Yeah, he was very much involved. Ever since he was a little kid, he was always involved in parish life. He received his education through his grandfather, who basically was a deacon, although he was not ordained as a deacon. But he was always assisting the priest, because back then his grandfather lived a little bit more remotely, so priests had difficulty getting to all the little mm-hmm. towns within Dominican Republic. That's where my husband's from. So he was in charge of ministering the word, helping out with the sick, etc. So Franklin grew up with that upbringing mm-hmm. of his grandfather and seeing him as a servant. So, you know, it was great to see that I had met someone with the same spiritual connection as mine. And we married, you know, before marrying, of course, we grew up, we served the youth ministry within our parish life and everything. So it was great. So, then we got married, and working here at Catholic TV, you know, doing some of the services here at Catholic TV, he was approached by Cardinal Law at the time and said, you know, would you be interested in becoming a deacon? At the time, he wasn't married. And he's like, well, I've never thought of that. You know, then he got married. And then Cardinal Sean O'Malley also asked him, have you thought about mm-hmm. being a deacon? And he's like, you know, I've been thinking about it, mm-hmm. but yeah. So he would get questioned by other priests as well. And then he finally answered that calling. He said, you know, I do have that calling, and I'd love to be a deacon. So for me, of course, it was a surprise.
Right.
But I said, I'm all for it. I'm here to support you. And of course, they go through the discernment process. So with that discernment process, we are invited, the wives, to be part of that first 2 years of discernment. And it was beautiful, because I was able to go to the classes with him, formation, and pray along with him for discernment to see if it really was his calling. And in the end, it truly was.
And so he has been a deacon. He's been ordained.
It's been 3 years. He was ordained in 2014.
Okay, so I liked what you said about the whole servant part, because I just mm-hmm. had the opportunity to cover the diaconate ordination in mm-hmm. the Diocese of Springfield, and that just kept coming up, how they're servants, just like as the Lord washed our feet.
Yeah.
And I loved you know, them talking about that reading, that deacons are called to serve in that way.
That's correct. Well, the word deacon comes from diaconus, mm-hmm. which means servant. And the deacon is a sacramental sign to the church and to the world of Christ, who came to serve and not to be served.
Right.
So we are all called to be servants, to serve within the church, but they're specifically in that role to serve the church. And of course, they do not consecrate the host.
Right.
They do not listen to confessions, but they do everything else that a priest would do. And it's to be that right hand or extra hand that the priest needs within the parish life to serve and to go out there and be more of a social servant.
And I think your marriage is such a witness to others. How long have you been married?
We've been married now, it's for 15 years.
God bless you. So, yeah, but here you are,
15 years.
Growing up in the church together. So this, mm-hmm. this just makes like my heart just skip a beat yeah. that you guys met in youth ministry, because I'm always praying for holy spouses
yeah.
for my children.
It
join the youth group.
Blessing.
And here you guys get married, but you have many different activities that you're running, including the youth group. Tell us about your parish and what you're doing there.
Sure. So once Deacon Franklin was assigned to Sacred Hearts in Malden, that's mm-hmm. the parish that we were assigned to. I grew up at St. Mary's of the Annunciation in Cambridge. That's where I grew up within my youth ministry. Now at Sacred Hearts, we are working with the Hispanic community. As a deacon, he's the deacon of all communities.
Right.
There's a Vietnamese community, English-speaking and Spanish, but I focus more in the Spanish community. Mm-hmm. So we are working with music ministry. That's one of the areas that I'm helping out with. Also catechism, mm-hmm. and we're working towards creating a youth group as well. So we have a group of kids who are very excited and working and preparing. They're actually taking music classes. That's one of the ways we've hooked them
yeah.
to try to interest them. And so they're learning to play
guitar.
An instrument and a guitar, and we're working with them. So it's kind of like what we're called right now, the Archdiocese is calling us to do, disciples and mission.
Right.
And so that's what we're working towards, and that's what my focus is.
Then last question, as a mom, you have a 10-year-old and a 14-year-old.
Yes.
I think there's a lot of people in maybe it would be the media, the popular culture that says, you know, if you look at the future of the Catholic Church, it's just really sort of a dark forecast that, you know, the numbers are not growing. You see something different, I think.
I do. You know, we can't deny those statistics. If we do not focus on evangelizing our own kids, then that statistic will become true.
Right.
Our focus is to, you know, be the parents of Christian kids. We need to bring them, as a baby, bring them to church.
Right.
Yes, they make noise. That's okay.
That's okay.
You want a church filled with noise of children running or not screaming.
Right.
But, you know, it's important to have them there. And it's part of the growing up upbringing.
Right.
So my kids are now altar servers.
Right.
They're also helping and learning an instrument to play music. And so it's part of submersing them in an active church, not a dead church.
Right.
Of course, no one's going to want to go to a dead church.
Right.
And I came to know Christ as a child, but also through youth ministry.
Right.
And one of the blessings is that you will forever be young.
Yeah.
So,
well, Jesus is joy. And
exactly.
I think, and if we admit that and show people that.
So that's exactly what I try to transmit to my children. Mm-hmm. Franklin and I try to transmit to that is a youthful Christ mm-hmm. and a youthful God. And so far, they're still hooked.
And Jesus said, let the children come to me.
Absolutely.
Always. So you're doing a beautiful job.
Well,
congratulations to you and your husband. And thank you so much for joining
us
today.
Well, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.